Somewhere in the shadow of the tree of life, you were forged from suburban concrete. Planted and grown in the image of a parasite who taught you how to cut tenuous roots into the streets of everyone who affirms you. Deep enough to sever all the roadmaps you wanted to use as a raft to float downstream. And so you anchored yourself to a locked bedroom. Danced emphatically to the love song of validation. You sharpened your self-hatred like an axe every night, dreaming of the day a gust of motivation could topple you from the second floor canopy, and mute every conversation held just out of earshot. One day that gust will come, but you won't fall. Instead, your roots will tear through the streets, a shipwreck, looking for an ocean. Life moves more quickly than anyone is comfortable admitting. If you slow down, you'll realize the land has a language you didn't know you spoke. You've been missing the air of free verse whispering quietly on a roadside. Take time to listen. And fill the empty pages of your veins with the poetry of the universe.
Strange face with your eyes, so pale and sincere. Underneath, you know,
some landscapes speak with a voice soft and flat. Some voices rise in waves high enough to shake your branches. Let them consume you with the stories they tell in their sterling repose. Give every memory the space to wrap its arms around the torso of your mind. Deep inside the forest, the choir of a mountain sings the only happy song you aren't tired of listening to. And the chorus was etched into your soul long before you ever grew leaves. Stand in the echo and use your ears to touch whatever it feels like to be ancient. Food is the closest thing you have to becoming a part of every place you go without resting a single root to the ground. And so eat what feels good and always pick the window seat. So you can enrapture yourself in the same light that bathed you the first time you opened your eyes. Those eyes can see a world that stretches on much longer than this city can afford to grasp. Make like the weather, and move to the next place only after you've finished exploring this one. Leave some intangible part of your spirit here for the next soul to pick up. Moist earth from a long-forgotten storm. This place looks different. The trees grow in all directions, and every one of them has rings that parallel the forest you call home. Let them see your roots. Let them see the tears in your trunk. Let them see the vulnerability in your every footprint.
It's Emma.
Emma, nice to meet you.
I love the way the shadows fit in this area.
Observe the posture they've learned to cultivate. Absorb their words as nutrient-rich soil. Find sanctity in the fertility of a stranger's voice. A stranger's smile. A stranger's story. And let those stories nourish your spirit like your home once nourished you. And just like your home, leave them with only the promise that your roots will grow stronger in the soil they've taught you to fortify. When you travel far from the city, far from its symptoms, far from anything that will keep the sun from setting on the valley of your optimism. You will wake up the parasite that sleeps in your mind. The one that wants you to forget the bright memory of good days spent with loving friends. It wants to hollow out your trunk and break the branches where these thoughts live. And when the sun begins to sink below the mountains, it'll feel like the world is on fire. Hot enough to scorch those leaves. But when the night comes, let it in. It's no different than day. Whatever grows in the shadow of your body is just a dark paragraph painted on the emotional encyclopedia of your life. The parasite is part of you. Be kind to it. Give it shelter. And maybe one day, a long time from now, your compassion will teach it to live on its own in some other place. You'll learn that love for the world is not found, it's created. The ingredients grow like fruit from your soul. You memorize the recipe the first time you felt the unending scope of your mother's arms. It percolates with an expectant energy every time you feel free again. Every time you see something that sinks your stomach. When it hits, it blows in your face with a welcoming air that shakes your entire body. It feels effortless, and it usually is. But in all your adoration of the natural world, you've ignored the most difficult love to keep. The kind you reserve for yourself. You've forgotten on which branch the fruit of your self-worth grows, so you've been stealing it from others. Being alone will help you realize the only reason your roots are weak is because you've been taking more than just fruit. You've been trying to plant yourself in the soil of everyone around you. When you learn to let your good days nurture your bad days, your parasite will withdraw from your thoughts, and you'll rise again. It'll leave a vacancy in the part of your mind that needs loving. And maybe in the future, you'll become the kind of person whose roots are strong enough to grow there.